comment below what you do for clinical experience, whether that's volunteering, job, anything that probably stands out. But what is something that you've been doing over the past few weeks? I kind of want to hear it.
Lab reports, all online. Absolutely love lab reports online. I don't even have to go in person to the lab this week due to everything. So very convenient to just have everything on video. Yeah, I'm gonna not finish with this quite yet, but I'll get right back to it.
It's a beautiful sunny day. We're on our way to volunteering.
Here we go.
Right now, just gonna have a trip from all the way from Denton all the way to Dallas. In Texas, we went from freezing to single digit weather in the temperature, and all the way to now it's what, 71 degrees out. It just feels so weird. And then classes are back up again. So a little bit of what I do over at volunteering is that I give boxing lessons and I conduct help out with workouts and exercises with people with Parkinson's disease. People ask me all the time, why would you consider this clinical experience? You're doing it over at Performance Center. You're not doing it at like a hospital. If you're not doing it in a hospital, it's not a clinical experience. I don't listen to all that. Usually I'm dealing with it's really what you consider as clinical experience is what you do and what you're doing and kind of like what you're able to tell about that, what you got from it. So in this case, yes, I'm working with a clinical population. Giving them boxing lessons is part of their treatment. So overall, I'm working with physical therapists. So people with Parkinson's disease, right? They go visit their neurologist, maybe their physical rehabilitation physician, get prescribed to go to conservative, non-invasive treatments, right? Such as physical therapy, occupational therapy, maybe injections. Yeah, brain stimulation therapy as well. But in this case with physical therapy, the physical therapist happens to revolve around boxing. The neurologist refers to physical therapy. This physical therapist specifically refers them to their own program, which is boxing. The organization I'm with is Rocksteady Boxing, but overall, we still go over the same 30-minute evaluations with patients and consider their follow-ups. Their treatment plans are these exercises, and I'm there to assist. It just happens so that I have a background in boxing, martial arts more so. I'm great with dealing with the clinical population such as this, right? This guy. Then there's these special type of warm-ups, these exercises that allow them to stimulate their brain, help with their balance, their cognitive function, their cognitive bandwidth per se. And we later then, you know, I help them put on their gloves. We get right into boxing. Usually they're on the bag. Sometimes they jump in and off with me with focus mitts. And then later on, we do a second part where it's just normal, like speed ladder. Like it's just normal exercises, a little bit of stretching. And so, for instance, we do a little bit of like footwork, like with the speed ladder and all that. It's really great with what we do. I've really enjoyed it, getting to know them, see that they still want to come back, understand that they're going through something that may not be curable, that it's still with them, but they're still making an effort to improve and want to improve their own daily function of living. So that's why I love seeing that.
It's the time with a kickstand, thinking of a plan to get quick bands, falling in deep with the quicksand, flag on my ass, no quick brand. I was packing on the ground, got my way up, had beef in the streets, had to stay up. Betty Crocker showed me how to bake a cake, bro. Doing that, put everything I love at stake, bro. Since it's just the time with a kickstand, thinking of a plan to get quick bands, falling in deep with the quicksand, flag on my ass, no quick brand. I was packing on the ground, got my way up, had beef.
Yeah.
Is this good?
Squeeze.
All good?
Yeah, it's good.
Here. All good?
Yeah.
Squeeze. Ready to fight?
Put him up.
I'm gonna fight.
One more time because it's so much fun.
Alright, Larry, you ready?
10-year-old girls do jumping jacks.
Let's do it.
Let's get started.
Alright. 10 jab cross, 4 jumping jacks.
I am
Oh, well, I want to go home.
Let's go.
All right, bring them on. Come on.
Hook, hook. Hook, hook. Side.
Right there.
Right there? Really have to put my fist, put some pressure into it. Okay, we're done for good. Gotcha.
Okay.
See if we get some water. I'm just tossing them.
Everybody count it out. Everybody up, now we back down. All our pain and sweat was for this moment right now. All from different places, but we came with each other. We came together as a team, but we leaving as brothers. Standing next to one another while we hold up our colors.
I'm gonna look into the camera and tell my mama I love her. Cause
this boy is not boy. It's the day that I have always dreamed.
So we're over at Sam's Club. I'm just filling up a little bit. First, we're gonna go ahead and fill up my gas. Then we're gonna go over to a car wash where I can find one. And then we're gonna go ahead back to Denton and we're gonna go study a little bit of MCAT, see what I have to do for the next few weeks, plan out my week. Overall, great. I had a great time. Wasn't really a smooth transition out from the boxing center, but I had a great time. After we did like our little shadow boxing with the line, so me and Derek just sat down, talked a bit, joked around, and yeah, said bye. Now here around the Flower Mound area. And I'll comment below what you do for clinical experience, whether that's volunteering, job, anything that probably stands out, but what is something that you've been doing over the past few weeks? Kind of want to hear it. Yeah.
Final song.
So as you can tell, I'm back home. I had an organization meeting. I was able to give like my little spiel, a 30-minute talk. I wasn't able to give it last week due to everything with the power outages and so forth. I just got done with homework. I'm reviewing the MCAT a bit, so I'm looking over what I should be doing for tomorrow. Don't want to sleep a little bit too late, but planning on going to the gym, seeing what else I can do. Again, with Parkinson's disease, yeah, that's what I've been doing since September, giving boxing lessons to all of them and kind of interacting with their physical lifestyle, keeping them up to date on what they have to be doing. And I'll usually go every Monday and Wednesday. I know towards the summer, they're gonna be opening up a lot more. So hopefully I'll get a couple more volunteering hours through that. But yeah, it's very fun. I enjoy being in that environment. I get to do it along with my sparring partners, Derek and Hamza. Go ahead and make sure to subscribe, like, and I'll go ahead and see y'all next time.
Oh my God, Derek.
I'm so big.
Derek's so big, bro. Like